Hello and welcome to Longfleet at Home. I'm Susie and I'm the pastor of Longfleet Baptist Church, and this is our church online. I'm sure, like me, you have been horrified watching the news over the past few days to see the unfolding situation in Ukraine. Just awful pictures of the war-torn country. I'm sure, like me, you just can't believe that it's happening. Especially if you've got links in Ukraine, and I know many of you do. I went to Ukraine in 2019 with Dnipro Hope Mission, got my DHM t-shirt on, and just met some of the people who are just lovely, lovely people, and so willing to share whatever they had, even if they didn't have very much. And I think it's fair to say that I've never experienced such a warm, loving welcome in any church as we received from the Christians in Ukraine. It was really wonderful when we went and spent time with them. And so it's just awful when you see pictures of apartment blocks being bombed and people fleeing. And of course, we find ourselves scanning the pictures for faces that perhaps we recognise. It's just, words fail me. It's just awful, isn't it? But we really want to do all that we can to help support our dear friends and people, whether we know them or not, when we see how much they're suffering in Ukraine. And of course, we can do what we can, but there's still often a sense of helplessness, isn't there? Especially when you're many thousands of miles away, or at least many hundreds of miles away. And you wish so much that you could change the situation yourself, that you could take people's pain away, that you could make it easier. And of course, it's not just situations of war where we wish that. Quite often, we just wish that we could take our loved ones' pain away, don't we? We see our families suffer, perhaps, our friends suffering, and we just long to be able to make it all better as quickly as possible. We pray and we pray for them. And sometimes we pray for a miracle, and sometimes that happens and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes we are left with that uncertainty where we just don't know what's going to happen next. And we don't know how God is going to intervene, if God's going to intervene, how things are going to work out. And it's at times like that when we're left with that uncertainty, and that perhaps sometimes it even challenges our faith because we don't understand why such suffering is still ongoing. But it's at times like that that we can find comfort in the Bible. It's tempting to want to, sometimes to want to run in the other direction, because we might find ourselves feeling an anger with God even. Why are you allowing this to happen? We sometimes find ourselves praying, or perhaps thinking, even if we're not actually saying it. We serve a God who is no stranger to suffering. If he was a distant God, if he was one who wasn't bothered by the agony of his creation, he certainly wouldn't have come to earth as Jesus, and he certainly wouldn't have gone through the suffering on the cross that he did for our sakes, so that we could have a renewed relationship with God, and so that we could be forgiven and have an everlasting life beginning now and going on into eternity. That's the sort of thing that can give us hope. But also, it's not enough just to sort of say, oh, it'll be all right one day, and when we go to heaven, everything will be fine. I spoke to somebody recently, actually. I met somebody whose memory of church was just that. He'd gone to church as a child and was basically told everything here is awful, but it'll be fine once we die and go to heaven. And you didn't find much comfort in that. But actually, when you look into the Bible and look into God's word, that's where we can find strength for the right now. Right now, where we are struggling with difficulties, unbelievable suffering, we're seeing it when we're not able to help people as we would want to, perhaps. Or perhaps we are going through that suffering ourselves right now, and we don't know how we're going to face tomorrow. Have you ever thought that, when something is just so painful and you think, I just don't know how I can go on. I just don't know how I can face another day like this. And sometimes you might have been feeling like that, and you might have had perhaps a friend or somebody who just comes alongside you and just helps you to bear that burden just by dint of the fact that they're there. That's the sort of thing that we can find with our loving Heavenly Father as well. And I just wanted to read to you a couple of verses from Isaiah 41. Those of you who know me will know that these are some of my favourite verses. We've spoken about them before, haven't we? But they just seem particularly applicable now. And God says in verse 10, "Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand." Just such encouraging words. Sometimes when we feel helpless, when we feel physically helpless, we turn to perhaps a walking aid, or perhaps a handle, or somebody else's arm. We need that support to help us stand up, to help us to move forward. And that's what God is offering us here. He is offering us his victorious right hand, his strong right hand. He says, "I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand." Sometimes when we feel wearied by the fight, when we feel we have no strength left, either physically or spiritually, it's good to know that we don't have to muster that strength ourselves. It's good to know that God has promised that he will provide that strength, that he will provide us with the support we need to fight another day. So if that's you today, either because you are seeing the suffering of others and feeling helpless, or because maybe you are suffering yourself and feeling helpless, be encouraged by these words. "Don't be afraid, says God, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand." Let's pray. Lord, it's so easy to have that sense of defeat, or to feel exhausted, either by suffering ourselves or by watching the suffering of others and just feeling so helpless. So, Lord, we want to lift to you, first of all those for whom we have the deepest love and concern. We think of all those who are going through unbearable suffering at the moment. And Lord, we pray on their behalf. We claim on their behalf this promise that you have written in your word, which says that you will strengthen, you will help, you will uphold with your victorious right hand. And so Lord, just now I pray for anyone who really needs to hear that just now. Lord, whether they're watching this or not, whether they're listening to this or not, but whoever needs a really special touch, support of your victorious right hand, Lord, I pray for that now. And Father, we pray for your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thank you, folks. It is good to spend a little bit of time with you again. But please do just keep praying and keep trusting, because God has promised that he will give us the strength that we need. So let's trust him for that. Okay, well, cheerio for now. I will see you next time. And until then, have a good couple of weeks. I will see you soon. Bye for now.